Hello, welcome back to Good Morning KU for the Thursday edition. I'm Travis Calvin.
And I'm Caroline Johnson.
We were supposed to host last week where we were completely unprepared. This week, again. Again, a little bit unprepared. We were running and scrambling for the last couple seconds there.
Yes.
But we're back and we're going to actually give you a good show. We're prepared this time.
Yes, and it's beautiful out and we're ready and we're happy about that.
75 degrees yesterday, which felt amazing compared to 20 with a wind chill of -3.
I was sweating walking on campus for the first time all semester, which was oddly an amazing feeling.
I was sweating in class.
Yeah.
All the classrooms are really hot.
The libraries are really hot too.
I haven't been in a library this year.
Well, consider yourself lucky.
It was, the temperatures are here to stay though. I think I saw forecasts that said all through spring break and all through when they get back, it's supposed to stay really warm. It's going to be really nice.
It's hopefully not going to be anything like 2 years ago, because I remember getting back from spring break and it flurried snow in mid-April, and it was the worst thing.
Yeah, I remember that too. I think I was a junior in high school and there was just an inch of snow on the ground for the start of spring break, and I was just kind of, oh.
Yeah,
just
not
just
a
like
good feeling.
Very, very disappointing to start spring break off with snow, but that's not happening this time. I think the coldest is going to be is about 55.
Right. At least we've barely had any snow this year. We really.
I like snow for Christmas time, but for after Christmas and there's just like annoying amounts of snow.
Although we didn't get any snow days, and that's the biggest bummer. But
well,
maybe next year. I won't be here, but maybe you'll have your first college snow day.
Yeah, I've got 3 extra years to do that, so I'm hoping there's probably be one in there. But spring break's coming up. Do you have any big spring break plans?
I am actually going out to LA to visit my brother because he lives there.
Huh.
So I've been to California, but never Santa Monica, which is where I'm going. So I'm pretty excited.
I went there 3 years ago, and it was a really pretty place. I really liked it.
Yeah,
Los Angeles is like it's one of my favorite cities, I think, in the United States.
Yeah, I'm so excited, and I've been to San Francisco, so that's what I have to compare it to. But I can't wait. How about you?
I get to have all 4 of my wisdom teeth yanked out.
Oh man!
Starting on Monday. So that's gonna be.
That is rough.
Yeah, like everybody else is going places, and I'm just laying on my couch with cotton in my mouth. It's gonna be a bit of a bummer.
You can have a chance then to catch up on some TV shows or movies or.
Probably. I've got Netflix hooked up. I'll probably just be on that all throughout my.
Speaking of movies, I was
recovery.
Just watching something about this that Zoolander 2 is coming out, and Ben Stiller and Owen Wilson walked at Paris Fashion Week to promote their movie. It was this big deal.
It may be a big deal, but I've never seen Zoolander.
What?
But I don't know. I've just never seen
Zoolander. You've never seen Zoolander?
No.
Well, you should put that on your list of things to watch while you're on your couch with your wisdom teeth.
I might, but I honestly, like, I've maybe heard of it a couple times, but I really have no idea what it's about.
It's a fan favorite, for sure.
What is it even about?
It's about 2 male models who are competing for, like, winning the best title of best male model of the year or whatever. So Ben Stiller and Owen Wilson are going against each other the whole movie, and it's just really funny humor.
Okay.
What you'd expect.
I'll check it out then.
Yeah.
That'll give me something to do while I'm
any TV shows you're excited
about? I need to catch up on The Walking Dead.
Oh.
I'm way behind on that.
It's a good one.
I'll have plenty of opportunities to do that. That's going to go ahead and wrap it up for our opening segment. We're going to be right back with the news, I believe.
Where you go to college makes a statement about you. This place will become a part of you, your identity for life. The University of Kansas, a great place to be you.
Good morning. morning. I'm Mary Kate Baker, and joining us now we have Teanna, and we're here to talk more about spring break. I've heard people who are going on cruises, I know people who are studying abroad, or we have Travis, who knows, getting his wisdom teeth pulled out, which kind of stinks, sorry. But joining us, we have Teanna, who you're actually going to go visit a friend. Mm-hmm. Is that what you're doing?
Yep, in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Okay. So keeping it kind of chill, but it should be fun.
I know a lot of people who are doing the same thing. I'm doing the same thing, visiting friends from our hometown. How are you guys getting there? Are you guys going to drive?
Drive. Okay. It's about 11 hours, and there are four of us going, so it could be interesting.
It could be fun, but we'll do some rotating.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, so when you guys are there, I've never been mm-hmm. to that part of Tennessee. Actually, I don't even think I've ever been to Tennessee, if I can remember. But what do you have anything planned?
Not anything for sure. My friend actually just moved there in December, okay. So she's just gonna kind of show us around, visit her and. Yeah, do some fun things.
Well, so she's going to show you her new town. You're from Lawrence,
yes.
Correct? So she's seen your hometown plenty of times. Mm-hmm. And this will be, I'm sure, a nice chance to go and see hers.
Yeah.
Well, good, safe travels. Safe travels for everyone. Remember to, take precautions on this break and make safe decisions. And when we're back, we'll have the news.
My name is Lady Koutou.
And my name is Shia Wan. This is your Thursday Good Morning KU News update. The police officers were shot outside the Ferguson Police Department earlier Thursday as the Missouri town saw a new demonstration following last week's release of a damning Justice Department report alleging bias in the police department and court. KSDK-TV reported one officer was shot in the shoulder and one was shot in the face. Both officers are conscious but in serious condition.
Members of the KU Student Senate will travel to Topeka today to support Lifeline 911 legislation. This is the bill that would allow amnesty for students under the age of 21 to ask for help if they need medical attention after drinking. Student Body President Morgan Said Saeed says that the bill is about general safety and responsibility.
The KU Bookstore held its grad fair on Tuesday and Wednesday afternoon this week. This fair was held in the ballroom of the Kansas Union from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. This event gave graduation students the opportunities to purchase their caps, gowns, and as well as purchase graduation announcements and classrooms. Eligible students will walk down the hill to Memorial Stadium on Sunday, May 17th.
Two students were expelled this week from the University of Oklahoma after a video surfaced of them leading a racist chant. The Oklahoma chapter of the fraternity Sigma Alpha Epsilon was kicked off campus after the video was released. One of the expelled students issued an apology while the family of the other also issued one. OU is currently in a healing process as tension among students is high as a result of the incident.
And that will wrap it up for today's news update. Stay tuned and we'll be back with Travis with the sports.
Where you go to college makes a statement about you. This place will become a part of you. Your identity for life. The University of Kansas, a great place to be you.
Hello, welcome back. I'm Travis Calvin and I'll be covering some sports for today. The men's basketball team will be taking on the TCU Horned Frogs in the quarterfinals of the Big 12 Conference Tournament today. TCU defeated Kansas State last night 67-65. Kansas has defeated TCU twice, 64-61 at TCU and 81-72 in Lawrence. KU will be taking on the Horned Frogs at 1:30 today. However, they will once again be without power forward Cliff Alexander, who Coach Bill Self has said will not play until the Alexander family and the NCAA have met to determine Alexander's full eligibility. Perry Ellis will be wearing a brace on his sprained knee for the rest of the year, and is a game-time decision to play against TCU. Ellis injured his knee in the first half against West Virginia and has been out ever since. If Ellis has no pain in his knee, he plans to play as normal.
The women's basketball team will be searching for a new head coach after the athletics department dismissed Bonnie Hendrickson on Monday. Hendrickson led the Jayhawks to the Sweet 16 appearances in 2012 and 2013, but have never had a has never coached a team that has finished above 500 in Big 12 play. KU athletic director Shehan Zenger did not discuss details when the new coach would be hired. The number 23 women's softball team will be hosting their first home games of the season starting on Friday for the Jayhawk Invitational. Kansas is 21-2 so far this season and bounced back from a 4-0 loss against Chattanooga with an 11-3 victory over Chattanooga the following day. KU plays Northern Colorado, Idaho State, and Nebraska Omaha on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, respectively. The struggling 6-11 men's baseball team will play host to Michigan for a three-game series on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. KU has lost three straight in the Hoagland Ballpark, including most recently a 2-8 loss to Central Michigan on Tuesday. First pitch for Friday's matchup is set for 3 p.m. That's going to wrap it up for sports and for the whole show. Thanks for watching today, and stay tuned tomorrow at 10 a.m. for the next Good Morning KU. Have a great day.